No matter how hard we try to keep our kids out of harm's way, there's always a chance they could get injured. That is why today on And Mum Pedia Pro 3 Coffee Group, we are talking toddler first aid with St John paramedics Courtney Rain and Blake Murray. Good morning to you both.
Good morning. Good morning.
Really nice to have you here because it's just so important. Blake, let's start with you. What are some of the most common injuries or the most common accidents involving Kiwi kids?
So 60% of all injuries on children under 5 occur within their own home. Of those, ones requiring to go through to hospital often involve falls, burns, poisoning, small fingers and appendages getting caught in places they shouldn't be, and small objects being inserted in places they certainly shouldn't be.
Because this is the thing, kids are really curious and they want to insert and put, you know, and have a look at everything that's going on. Courtney, what do parents need to remember when their child is injured?
Well, when our kids get hurt or injured, it can be a really stressful and traumatic experience as a parent, but that's multiplied for the child. So it's really important that our parents are keeping calm. If the child hasn't been hurt or hasn't been ill before, they quite often look to their parents for cues about how they should be feeling or what they should be doing. So if mum and dad are nice and calm, it's going to make our job a lot easier because the child's going to be calm. If mum and dad are freaking out a little bit, it's going to make things a little bit more hard.
Mm. And that's the thing too as a parent, because not only are you so concerned for your child, but you're also, you feel that guilt that this injury happened under your watch, which is an awful feeling as well, but you've got to keep it together for them.
Absolutely.
Blake, let's talk about choking. What would that look like and what should we do?
Yeah, so firstly we need to determine whether we have a full obstruction or not. If it's not a full obstruction, the child will still be able to breathe, potentially communicate and talk, make noises. If you don't have any of those signs, then we more likely are looking at a full obstruction. If it's not a full obstruction, we just need to try and keep the child calm, encourage them to cough to try and remove the obstruction, and just monitor them very closely. However, if it is a full obstruction, obviously it's a lot more serious and we need to do something about it now. So firstly, call 111 or have someone call 111 on your behalf. And then we go to our first aid, which initially involves 5 back blows. I'll demonstrate
on Courtney here.
Yeah, so they're quite firm back blows between the shoulder blades and about that sort of strength. It's stopping between each one to check and see if we've dislodged the object.
Right.
And if we haven't, we carry that on for 5 goes, and then we'll have a go at some chest thrusts. So we teach to do 5 chest thrusts, which is the same as doing CPR, only without the breathing. Again, stopping between each one just to see if we've dislodged it, if we've managed to clear that airway.
Because the thing with the full obstruction is that they'd be silent too, wouldn't they, the child?
That's correct, yeah, eerily silent. And they're not able to move air in and out of the airway to generate any noise or to scream or to cry. So if any of those things are better signs than silence.
So we as parents need to know what to do, because we can't wait for you, can we?
No, time's critical.
Okay, well, this is very, very good advice. What about burns, Courtney, if our child suffers a burn, which is very easy in winter with heaters around?
Yes, heaters and cups of tea. I think probably the first thing to talk about is prevention and trying to prevent those burns from happening, making sure that the kettle's at the back of the bench. If you're cooking, the handles are pointing towards the back. And like you said, with winter coming, heaters and fires, making sure that the grates are up and that they don't, you know, squeeze around them like my little fella did. So once they have burnt themselves, we want to cool the burn under running water for 20 minutes, absolutely no less. If you have called for us...
How long? 20 minutes?
20 minutes.
So no one does it that long, do they? You never do it long enough.
Must be 20 minutes. If you've called for us and we arrive and it hasn't been 20 minutes cooled under the tap, we won't go anywhere until it's been cooled for 20 minutes.
And is it icy cold water or just...
No, just room temperature, tepid, cool water. Icy water, you don't really want to do that. And you want to try and keep the rest of the child warm and dry as well. So if it's just their arm, try not to panic and throw the whole kid in the shower. Just keep their arm under running water. If you can't get it running, like you've got a bucket of water, just try and drip the water over top of it. You really want to try and keep it rotating.
Okay, keep it moving.
Not submerse it into the bucket.
It's really interesting too, because what you're talking about there, having your pot handles and everything always in. My youngest is 11 now, but I still do that automatically. They're running past and they knock a pot handle out to them. It's just like instinct.
Doesn't take much.
So what if a caregiver is the one who collapses? What should we teach our children, our toddler to do?
I think a good place to start is teaching them their home address, so that if they do need to call for help, they know where they live, we can find them in the emergency. And St John have released an ambulance song, which helps teach our children how to call 111.
We remember the song very well.
Yeah. Also, how to unlock mum or dad's phones is a very important one these days. You know, we're seeing a lot more people with cell phones than home phones, so they need to know how to unlock and be able to dial 111 on your phone.
Can you dial it from the lock screen? I think you can, can't you?
Because if you adjust your settings, you can.
But because I'm not entirely sure that I want my children access to my phone, resetting everything in it. But you're right, they do need to know how to do that. Is there anything else you'd like to add? Keep our children safe? I think we've covered quite a lot of there, haven't we?
Yeah.
Accidents will happen.
Yes. Accidents will happen. Don't beat yourself up. Do your
very
best.
Learn what to do when they do happen.
Yeah. That's great. Thank you so much for joining us today. Really good advice. Don't forget, St John is a charity and does amazing work in the community. Donate, I do, every month, or volunteer at stjohn.org.nz. The Coffee Group is brought to you by Animum Pedia Pro 3, the only toddler milk with no added sugars. If you have any worries that you'd like addressed by our parenting panel... There we go, just that book. Message us on the Facebook page. One contributor will win this cool ebook from Ann Mum that allows you to record your voice, recording the story. Congratulations to this week's winner, Sarah Hughes. Thank you so much for your topic suggestion.